Okay, so if you're watching this video and it's the camera is aiming at some weird thing in the car, this is a 360 video, so all you have to do is just scroll with your mouse on the screen, or you can, if you're using a mobile device, turn your device and it should look around. So you're able to look around in this video. So this is Chelsea. She works here at Sparks Toyota, and she's a automotive wizard ninja, according to one of the managers. So, but this is the first time we're, you know, she's seen this car, so we're kind of learning about it together. I just went through the overview video and, you know, went through the features, so now it's the test drive portion. And, but yeah, I got my phone in here charging, and what do you think of it?
I'll tell you, I started with Toyota back in 2008, and this is the sleekest, sportiest Avalon, without a doubt, that I have seen. It, when I first saw it, when we pulled it up today, I had to take a double take. It's like, yeah, are you kidding me? That's like an Avalon?
It looks like a... It looks like it's competing with, like...
Lexus, Infiniti.
Yeah, exactly. So, and also the Camry, there's a lot of... upgrade. As far as the Camry, it went to a sportier look, and then now the Avalon, sportier
look. Absolutely.
And, but I heard that this thing's a little peppy. It's not like the previous models.
Oh, yes. I haven't tested it out, but I'm very excited to see what it's made of.
You think William will get mad if I give a little gas in a test drive?
I won't tell him.
Okay, we'll just... And then anybody's watching this, don't tell William, the one of the managers.
I'll tell you, this air conditioned seat is it's amazing, isn't it?
Yeah, I was thinking, I was like, I'm gonna freeze her out of the car when she gets in here because I like it really, really cold. Well, I've been out in the sun all day. When William let me know this was here, I was at Bird Island in Sunset Beach. You know where that is?
Oh, yeah.
I had to walk like 5 miles down there, and I was testing out a new drone that I got.
Mm-hmm.
And I was steaming hot, sweating, and all, you know, sand all over me. And then I find out this car is here, and I'm like, oh, great. And then I was like, can I do it tomorrow? And he's like, well, everybody's calling all their customers, and it's probably going to be sold by then. So I was like, all right, I'm on my way. So, so if I got sand and everything all over me, that's what happened. But yeah, this is nice. I like the steering. It's not too, like, loosey-goosey, you
mm-hmm.
know? Like, some of the luxury-type cars, they have, like, this... It turns to... Like, you can't feel the road, you know?
Yes.
This one, it's like it's really loose when you're sitting still, but when I was driving, it felt a little tighter.
It's definitely a change from the previous Avalons, you know? It's a lot sportier, you feel the road a lot more, but it's still very smooth and...
Well, it has that adjustable suspension, too. That they, uh-huh. Toyota, I don't think Toyota had that before, do they?
No.
It's like some kind of magnetic ride mm-hmm. type deal. Speaking of that...
How does the driver's seat feel, by the way?
Awesome. Yeah, both the driver and the passenger have full control, like up, down, and everything, mm-hmm. even on the passenger side. A lot of cars just have, like, basic stuff on the passenger, and then the driver gets all the fancy stuff. But
yes.
This one's, like... both sides.
Oh wow, lumbar support? Nice.
It's four-way, so there's the brake hold, so
mm-hmm.
I don't trust stuff like that. I'm not used to. It's like hard to trust it because I'm afraid I'm going to roll forward, but it's holding it. Same thing with the adaptive cruise control.
Yes.
I got sport S
and you have your
plus turned on.
Lane departure turned on. Now, you're familiar with how that works, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, the lane departure. I'll leave it on until it annoys me, and then I'll turn it off. That's what happens typically. But the radar, the cruise control, once I got used to it, the radar type, it's actually pretty nice on the highway.
Yes.
Because my car, I'm constantly changing. Like, I get behind some slowpoke, and I have to slow down. And
I have to stop and resume.
Yeah. So yeah, I like that. I don't have it on my car, but the next car I get, most likely will have it. Also, digital speedometer. So the Honda,
yes.
The Honda Accord can weep over that because, did you notice that the Honda Accord, the new one, doesn't have a digital speedometer?
I did.
Oh, you did know that?
Yes, okay. I did. Yeah.
So that's one thing you want to mention if somebody doesn't know. Wow. It's like downshifts easy. Oh, because mm-hmm. I had that sport mode on. It's the Sport Plus. So you got Sport, and then you got the Sport Plus. The S Plus.
I'd be curious to feel the difference.
Yeah, I'm going to... Once we get a little bit of room, I'll give it some gas and see what it feels like, and then we'll turn it to... Then we'll turn it to normal and see how it is. Eco, I don't know. I don't care for that.
Yeah, me either. I definitely like a feeling of a little bit more power, the stiffer suspension. What do you think of this screen here?
What is that, like a 9-inch screen?
Mm-hmm.
It looks good. The clarity, resolution, all that stuff's great.
It does. And it's not a good point on the dash, because I know, you know, with certain dashes, it's hard to see with the reflection, but look how bright it is out, and there's very visible.
Yeah, that's a... Now, I don't know if it comes with a microfiber cloth. I think if it doesn't, then that'd probably be a good idea for you guys to buy some and give them to customers when you sell one.
We have plenty.
Okay, you do? You do that? Okay, awesome. Because everything's, like, gloss black now. Mm-hmm. So every little fingerprint shows up. So yeah, I can feel some engine braking when I let go of the accelerator.
<That's>, sounds good.
Yeah.
And I am very glad we're test driving now. Chance while it's still here.
Yeah, William was concerned it was gonna be sold pretty soon since they only have one and everybody's calling their customers that wanted to see it.
We have had so many customers ask, when's the 19 coming out? Is it gonna be different? And it's so different.
The heads-up display, I notice it has a heads-up display, but it's really hard to see with the polarized sunglasses.
Mm-hmm.
That's pretty typical with those type of things. Now, if I turn my head to the side, it starts to be more visible because of the polarization.
So quiet.
So you give it gas.
Then you hear it.
That doesn't feel like an Avalon. That feels like something else. It's like it turns into a, I don't know, sounds pretty good though.
Mm-hmm. And it almost feels that you have more space here with the way they've designed the dash. Don't you love that, how everything goes in, these large vents, so it cools down.
Kind of
down
blends into the door, that, like, very, kind of Lexus look.
It
Lexus
is.
Like.
Very aggressive.
Let's see if I can...
We'll just ignore that speed sign for the moment.
Yeah. It actually tells me the speed limit down here.
Isn't that
65.
Awesome?
It just turned 65 right when I passed the sign. Sport mode turns off when I put cruise control on. I wonder, let's see if I cancel it, if the RPMs will go up. No. Let's go ahead and put it on normal. It said normal, not eco. Alright, let's see what happens. Alright. So yeah, it's about 1400 RPMs at 65 miles an hour. Something like that. Not bad. I love 8-speed transmissions.
Yes.
My car's got one and it's like awesome. I just came back from Virginia Beach and got 31 miles per gallon like the whole trip. Average. Couldn't believe it. For a car that has 305 horsepower.
Oh, gosh.
So. Yeah. That's amazing what they can do with new cars.
It is.
Like this one here, I mean, it doesn't feel, it feels like a, like, it turns into like a muscle car or something when you shift the gas. But then when you drive it normally, you don't have the exhaust note droning in the background like you would a muscle car.
So it gives you really the best of both worlds.
So you're just cruising along. I mean, let's see if that lane departure warning does
anything. And that, you can actually adjust the sensitivity.
I gotta turn, well, I mean, I'm not going too far. I'm not... thing about swerving. I don't want to do it. The drive's really straight too. It's It's not steering assisted, is it?
No. Well, the lane departure does have the steering assist, but you'll feel the steering assist engage once you go over the lane.
Oh, okay.
And it will beep to let you know. So far,
I love it. It's smooth, quiet. It's kind of a luxury, kind of like a comfortable luxury / sporty. I like the steering wheel too. The way it feels, it's kind of soft.
The leather act.
Perforated leather. Do you know if this is real leather in these seats, or is it the Softex?
I believe it's a Softex.
Okay. Which is probably better because it lasts longer.
Yes. Easier to keep clean, especially, you know, living around here, the beach. This passenger seat is so comfortable.
Yeah, this one is too. I didn't really... Oh, yeah. What?
That added that support lumbar. Underneath your legs, too. Oh, that is so nice.
That lumbar is like... Man,
it's intense.
Awesome. Yeah.
If you need
you get
it.
A back massage over here. Wow. Okay. It goes way up there, too. That's
it does.
I'm getting like a massage right now.
And the great thing is the memory seats, of course, so you don't have to worry about reprogramming your seat.
Getting in the car when I first, like, when you turn off the engine, the steering wheel, and the seat goes back, giving you more room.
There's your lane departure. And you also have the, I'm sure you're aware of this, pre-collision with the pedestrian detection as well.
Yeah. It's all, Toyota has like all kinds of safety features now.
And what I love, you know, is that they've made those core safety features standard on all models. So you don't have to, even though this happens to be, you know, one of our top-of-the-line models, you don't necessarily have to go all the way to the top of the line to benefit from having those safety features.
What's the lowest trim level on the new Avalon, do you know?
I believe it's going to be the XLE. You know, normally they introduce the, they bring in the loaded ones first, but we'll still have the XLE.
So this is the middle. And then the touring, and then you have the limited, which is the more luxury. This is more leading towards the sporty.
Absolutely.
And then that one is kind of like the more economical one. That makes it easy. It's weird because touring is typically the highest trim level, but in this case it's not.
Limited has always been our top of the line on the Avalon. I just want to check out the screen a little bit.
Has Apple CarPlay.
Oh, that's so amazing.
Android Auto is coming.
We are so excited about that.
I'm sure a lot of customers have asked for it.
Absolutely. And now it's here.
It has some kind of Amazon app, too, that I'm not familiar with. Some kind of voice recognition through Amazon.
Like dealing with Alexa?
Maybe that's what it was. Yeah, that's probably what it was. Yeah, I'm not familiar with that too much.
It's, you know, I haven't had a chance to play around with it yet. I'm excited to because it's brand new for us. But
Is it kind of like Siri, that kind of deal?
Or? From what I've heard, yes. But again, I haven't had a chance to really play around with it yet. I love this home screen because you can have everything right here on the screen. You can personalize it too, so.
Okay, so I got close to that lane.
Are you running off the road again?
Yeah, pretty much. No, it's the lines. They didn't draw them straight. I think that's what it is.
In my vehicle, I like to back it down to where it's not so sensitive. Mm-hmm. But it's really, you know, nice to personalize.
I think it's not too bad. It's only beeped at me twice, only because I've kind of really went over the line. I just want to, like, floor it all the time because of that exhaust.
I know. I love hearing it also. Noticing too, the visibility I think is greater in this Avalon compared to our previous body styles. Mm-hmm. Now, not that, you know, we really were lacking in visibility, but you know, with the way this pillar is positioned, the size, it's really good.
I think you're right, and also the rear glass, which is what has the blind spot and all that stuff for cross traffic.
Yes, that's
and
one of my
favorites. The backup camera is in the very center position. It's not offset. That's one of my things that annoys me is when they kind of offset the backup camera, and then we look in the view, it's like you have to account for the offset. So it's like, okay, where's the center of the vehicle compared, you know?
Absolutely.
And also it's made like it looks like the camera's made in the vehicle. It's not tacked on like in previous years. Just a lot of cars have this like tacked on look with the backup camera, but this looks more integrated.
Now, I do have to ask you, have you tried out the JBL as of yet?
No.
The sound system?
I can't really try it out until I get some copyright free music to play because I record it, you know?
Yep.
That's always a problem. I have to have some kind of copyright free music to play. And I do, like, I did a sound test on the Camry. Some music, and it sounded really good.
Oh, it's amazing. And I love that they've positioned the speaker to where it's kind of ear level.
Oh,
did you notice that?
Yeah, I didn't notice that. That's interesting. Now, notice it has a tweeter there in that back. It's right there, kind of close to your ear, too, isn't it?
Yep. Now, if we get a chance, you may have to give it some juice one more time. That exhaust sounds really good.
Wait, when we get to the acceleration lane up here, so that way I don't go too much over the speed limit. Dang, even at 65, it's that transmission definitely made a big difference.
I mean, how many seconds was that? Huh?
I don't know. It went from 65 to 75 like that.
Mm-hmm. Felt like 2 or 3 seconds. Even if that, it was very quick. See here. Now that I've tried out the air conditioned seat, I'm gonna try out the. I know it's summertime, but.
Up.
I love my heated seat.
I know, I'm probably freezing you out.
Oh,
the
no.
Seats are kind of loud when you turn them on high.
Mm-hmm.
But, flows more air. I'm going to put on low.
And what I like is, I have a little bit of back trouble, but this, the heat goes up a decent way.
Not
on
just
the back
on the
of your seat, yes.
That's good. After a long day's work. Does Terry still work upstairs?
He does.
Okay. So a long day of dealing with Terry and John and all that. And get a little tense. You gotta get some heat going on. Is William still working upstairs?
He is. Working downstairs. He just joined us back upstairs. So, it's been very nice. Oh my goodness, this is warm. I'm just turning this off.
I wonder if William will let me check out his Corvette one day.
You know, you could ask. He may monitor you while doing so.
I saw it out at the parking lot, and a long time ago, it was like back in 2015 or something. Mm-hmm. I was like, man, this is a nice car. And I didn't know it was Williams, and then it disappeared, and I was like, wow, I wish I could have talked to the owner about this car, you know? And then later on, I saw it on Facebook. It was his car the whole time.
Mm-hmm.
I was like, why didn't you tell me you had that?
Definitely very unique. You don't see many of them on the road
anymore.
It's like
perfect. I think it was right after he got it restored or repainted or something. It was like perfect.
Mm-hmm. You should tell him if he's ready to sell it, if you're interested.
No, I'm not. It's not a vehicle I can drive. I mean, I wouldn't. It's one of those cars where I would be afraid to drive it.
Yeah.
I need something. Like when I bought my Challenger, I told the dealer I wanted one that already has a scratch, you know, already not perfect, because I don't want a perfect car. I don't have to worry about it, because I do a lot of driving.
Oh, sure.
For like 25,000 miles on my car in the last year.
Wow. I'm pretty impressed.
Yeah,
I'm excited. Too. I'm so excited that this is our new Avalon. I can't wait until we get more.
Yeah, the previous generation Avalon, it was kind of like, you know, people were like, okay, this is getting a little bit dated now, you know. Same thing with the Camry before they changed the model. But then they did such a huge step up with both the Camry and this car that it's going to,
you know,
bring everybody back.
The last body style they came out with on the Avalon, comparing it to, you know, the previous generation, it was sportier, it was sleek, but this will knock your socks off. It's just something completely different. But I think, you know, it still will appeal to our Avalon buyers and our Avalon drivers that they still like that nice ride. Because mm-hmm. you have that.
You do. Especially this one with that that suspension. One last time.
Thank you very much. This has been great.
Yeah, thanks for riding with me. That way we're following the rules as far as test drives go. And hopefully I didn't cost you a customer or anything.
No, sir.
And I think I'm going the wrong way. He wants it back in the front,
mm-hmm.
but I need to aim it the other way.
Give you a chance to check out the turning radius.
That's true, yeah. And if any pedestrians run out in front of me, we'll check the braking too.
There you go.
Check out those lights.
Oh, nice.
Oh, check out the turn signal.
Ooh,
did you
I
see
love
that
before? No, I didn't realize that.
It has
that.
Like an animation to it.
Man, those headlights are...
Yeah, full LEDs. Just everything. Everything's LEDs. Except for one thing. This. Like yellow lights there. I was surprised that they had that.
Yeah.
But hey, that could be changed for just a few dollars, so I'm not worried about it. It's the headlights and all that stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So the thing is with turn signals and everything. That's why I like the way my car is all LED on the outside too, because during the day when your turn signal on, if it's not, the LED has like a really sharp, crisp, gets noticed. Like the older bulbs, you know, when the sun's shining on it or something like that, it may go unnoticed by the other drivers. But the LED is just, you know, really sharp and crisp. All right,
awesome.
So that's the end of the video. Thank you, Chelsea.
Thank you.